Shalom, back again with the truth. I'd like to say brakfa yahal bashim ashai, bashim rukakadash, double honor to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, blessed salutations to the elect worldwide, preaching the gospel in spirit and truth in the four corners of the earth, consistently and in a sincere manner. May the Lord have mercy upon the one third of Israel, men, women and children destined to repent. May the Lord bless them and keep them comfort. Keep them comforted. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans and Hispanics, and those that are scattered worldwide, no matter how you look like, but according to the scriptures, the characteristics and identification of the scriptures and the prophecies and the curses of Deuteronomy 28 that's upon our people, you guys are the true biblical Israelites, man. The descendants of the man named Israel. And your God is the God of Israel, whose name is Yahweh, and the Son's name, the Deliverer, the Savior, the King, his name is Yahweh Shai, not Jesus Christ. And you ought to worship both the Father through Yahweh Shai. And Yahweh Shai is considered as a so-called black man, according to scriptures. So yeah, I made a video previous to this. It's the same, I'm using the same scripture, but you know, I'm talking about a different variation of superpowers, man. You know, and not only that, even to this day and age, these days really, you've got the famous comic writer called Stan Lee promoting all his creations of superheroes, man, year after year, really. Yeah. And we're in the end times. And so it's kind of like a perfect timing with all these superhero movies coming out and came out, you know, from Incredible Hulk, from Thor. Spider-Man, Captain America, and, you know, Jake's favorite, Black Panther. Now you got Infinity Wars coming out. Well, it's great timing because we're in the end times and all these superpowers are going to become a reality. Starting with the elect of Israel, the prophets of Israel, they're going to receive and gain these superpowers from the Lord. Yeah, he's going to bless them with powers to show the Lord's power and give glory unto the Lord. A lot of these powers are going to be used to save them out of danger and just to show the beauty and glory of the Lord. But let's get straight into scriptures. This is the book of Isaiah 40. I'm going to start from verse 25. And it says, "To whom then will you liken me? Or shall I be equal, save the Holy One?" Same again, I read this before. Look, you can't compare no one with the Lord. "Lift up your eyes on high and behold who have created these things, that bringeth out their hosts by number. He calleth them all by names, by the greatness of his might, for that he is strong in power, not one faileth." The Lord is almighty and strong, man, and he can't fail. Everything he does is successful. "Why sayest thou, O Jacob, and speakest, O Israel, my way is hid from the Lord, and my judgment is passed over from my God? Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? By the everlasting God, the Lord Yahweh, the creator of the ends of the earth." The Lord created the earth, man. Yeah? Stop believing in that evolution, Big Bang theory, man. That philosophy of the so-called white man. This worldly university type of philosophy, man. That's false, man. When you come to the scriptures, you got to believe in the scriptures. How the hell are you going to say, oh, it was just a Big Bang? With all the intelligence that's on the earth. That's created. You got the sun and moon. You got the different seasons. Yeah? The earth is inhabitable for us. You want to talk about Big Bang. What kind of bullshit is that? There had to be a super entity of intelligence behind us. And that's the Most High Yahweh Bashim Ashai, man. Yeah? Talking about you evolved from fucking animals, from apes. Then why do apes and monkeys still exist if you evolved from it. What kind of bullshit is that, man? Esau, the so-called white man, the devil, always spewing out mad philosophies, man. Be careful and stay away from that. Believe in the Heavenly Father's powers, man. He created the earth, the heavens, and everything else, the universe. As well not known that thou hast not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, Yahweh, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not. The Lord don't give up. Neither is weary, never gets tired. There is no searching of his understanding. He's uncomparable, man. His mind is uncomparable. The way he works is uncomparable. He giveth power to the faint. Listen to that. He giveth power to the faint. And we are faint. We're faint, man. We're poor, we're weak. Our people are destroyed, man. We're the ones that need power, not these other nations. They're all above us, man. They're living off us, in fact, man. Especially the so-called white man. And to them that have no might, he increaseth strength, man. We don't have no might. We don't have no military might. We don't have nothing, man. We can't come against the so-called white man in a physical manner. Hell no, man. This is why you got to wait upon the Lord, man. He's going to establish his power. He's going to show his power to the world. And he's going to raise Israel up, man, in these last days. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall, man. That's it. We're weak and destroyed. We're battered. We're facing ailments. Facing pains. Verse 31. But they that wait upon the Lord. They that wait upon the Lord. You got to wait upon the Lord. You got to believe in the Lord. You got to have faith, man. Shall renew their strength. Renew. Back in the days in the ancient world, men had great strength. Great stature, man. King David slew in thousands of people, man, in battle on his ones. He can do that on his ones, man. Was it not him that he killed about 200 Philistines? You know? Slit up the foreskins and that, gave it to the king. You see? They shall mount up with wings as eagles. I've done this in a previous video. I showed you like an X-Men video of Angel flying and that, and showed you Hancock, which is a Jake, Will Smith, you know, showing you that, giving that imagery of that superpowers, man. But now I want to focus on this one. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint, man. They shall run and not be weary, man. Running fast and not getting tired, like the Flash. Yeah, like Quicksilver. Yeah, they're going to be beyond, because people, when you think of the fastest man, I know what you're thinking of. You're thinking of Usain Bolt. And see, that's one of our people. That's how you know we're the seed of Jacob, seed of Israel, because our people are dominant. Israel means he, prince of the power. Yeah, we're sons of God. So therefore, we carry the most godly attributes. That's why our people, so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, Hispanics, were very talented, got great potential, and very athletic. Yeah? Which very intelligent inventors as well. That's why we got the godly power, really, out compared to the other nations of the world. But there you go, man. They show, you see, we're going to run faster than Usain Bolt and run for longer, man. As it's saying here, they shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Yahweh Shai walked on water. Peter walked on water, you know, before he showed a lot of doubt. He still did it. That was a glimpse of superpowers, man. Yahweh Shai, who the world calls Jesus Christ. And this is scriptural, man. You got to believe this. In ancient times of war in Israel, I believe there was one man that can outride a horse, I believe. Yeah? Outride a horse. 18, start from verse 44. I'm just going to read quickly. And it came to pass at the seventh time that he said, behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea, like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare thy chariot. And you know, the chariots back then, they still have it now, like the queen's chariot. You know, got a chariot with the horses in front, you know, a form of transportation, a vehicle. And get thee down, that the rain, and that the rain stop thee not. And it came to pass in the meanwhile that the heaven was black with clouds and wind, and there was a great rain. And Ahab rode and went to Jezreel. So Ahab rode, in other words, he was on the chariot, traveling with the horses, and went to Jezreel. And the hand of the Lord was on Elijah. So that should already tell you, if the Lord's on you, something spiritual is happening. You know, spiritual power. And the hand of the Lord Yahweh was on Elijah. And he girded up his loins, he fixed himself, pulled up his garments, the ancient garments that he had, you know, tied it up around his groin area, you know, to allow flexibility, or like, you know, when you want to move more, if you're participating in exercise or a form of war. And it says, and he girded up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. So Ahab rode on horses and he ran. It says it there, ran. And it says before Ahab. Before, it means ahead. So you think about that, you know. This is his Bible, man. So yeah, man, with that, I'm going to say Shalom.